I would like to thank God for this moment.
And
another great opportunity I am to stand in front of the congregation.
To
once more bring forth the word of life.
Amen.
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 For those who weren't here last week with us, we looked at a strong subject. So to re-elaborate just a little bit, I'm
going
to ask for us to open up the book of
Malachi
or Malachi chapter 1,
Malachi chapter 1
verse
6. Verse 6.
Honore son père et un serviteur son maître. Si je suis père, où est l'honneur qui m'est dû? Si je suis maître, où est la crainte qu'on a de moi? Dit l'Éternel des armées, à vous, sacrificateurs, qui méprisez mon nom et qui dites, en quoi avons-nous méprisé ton nom? Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
So the Lord asked, if a son honors his father and a servant fears his master, but if I be both the father and the master, where is my honor and my fear?
Amen.
Amen. So we looked at the fear of the Lord and what it means for us and why we should have the fear of the Lord. Because the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. The fear of God is the fountain of life that snares you away from the snares of death. Amen.
Amen.
So we have to have the fear of the Lord. When we walk with the Lord, things might happen, but we won't fear the problem because we're fearing God who gives us the peace.
Amen.
Amen. That's what we talked about last week. Today, we're going to talk about the Spirit of Life.
Esprit à bon mot.
The Holy Spirit.
Saint-Esprit.
Amen.
Amen.
And what it means for us to have that Spirit of Life. We're
going
to ask the pastor to read Romans chapter
8.
Today we're going to talk about the entire Romans 8, but we're just going to start with Romans 8, 1 till 4.
To partager sur Romains 8, nous sommes de vous quatre ans par terre.
Romans
8, 1
till 4.
Romains 8, 1 à 4.
Tout en dit le bien connu Jésus-Christ, Romains 8, 1 à 4.
Amen.
Il n'y a donc maintenant aucune condamnation pour ceux qui sont en Jésus-Christ. En effet, la loi de l'esprit de vie en Jésus-Christ m'a affranchi de la loi du péché et de la mort. Car chose impossible à la loi, parce que la chair la rendait sans force, Dieu a condamné le péché dans la chair en envoyant à cause du péché son propre fils, dans une chair semblable à celle du péché. Et cela afin que la justice de la loi soit accomplie en nous qui marchons non selon la chair, mais selon l'esprit. Amen.
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 There is no more condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus had made me free from the law of sin and death.
Amen.
Amen.
How many of us see, even us ourselves, Christians these days, we don't necessarily walk after the Spirit. We walk after the things of the flesh. We are Christian, but we still consider ourselves to be led by the flesh.
Amen.
Amen. We shouldn't do that. As we walk after the Spirit, we are led to the righteousness of the law of Jesus Christ. That is fulfilled within us. For the law, for what the law could not do, and that was weak through the flesh, God sending his own son in likeness of the sinful flesh, for the sin condemnation in the flesh. Amen.
Amen.
God sent Jesus Christ as the flesh to remove the sin of the flesh, so he can give us an access to walk after the Spirit.
Afin que tu vas
tomber selon l'esprit. Amen.
Amen.
That the righteousness of the law may be fulfilled within us. Who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit.
Amen.
Verse 4 sends us to Galatians 5, verse 25.
Si nous vivons par l'esprit, marchons aussi selon l'esprit.
Amen.
Amen.
If we live in the Spirit, walk therefore in the Spirit.
Amen.
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 We will be set free from all the sin that leads us to death. When we walk after the Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
That's why verse 5 says, for they that are after the flesh do things that are of the flesh. Amen.
Amen.
Romans 8, verse 5 says, those that are after the flesh do what is of the flesh. But they that are after the Spirit do the things of the Spirit. Amen. The things that is that's giving joy to the to the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
That's why even if you tell people this verse right here, they won't understand.
What do
you mean? But what am I doing that's of the flesh? Anything that is taking you outside of the Scriptures, it's bringing you closer to death.
Amen.
That's a sin. That's what you're doing of the flesh. Your composure.
Kiboyo.
Your character.
Caractère na yo.
Your thoughts.
Makanisi na yo, to pense na yo.
Your way of being.
Façon na yo ya kozala.
If it's not aligned with the Holy Scripture,
so ki ezali aligné na ma komi masantu te,
it's of the flesh.
Ezali kibo mundu to ezali posa ya nzoto.
The Lord Jesus Christ told Nicodemus. God told Nicodemus.
Nzambe ebisi Nicodem.
The professor of theology.
Agalaki professeur ya théologie.
John 3 verse 3, God says this.
Jean 3, 6.
He asked them
a
question.
A question. Mutuna.
And Jesus responded.
Penzamba pesiye.
That which is born of the flesh is flesh.
Oyo ebotami na musuni ezali musuni.
But that which is born of the Spirit is the Spirit. Going exactly with what Galatians
5:25
says. If you walk after the Spirit, you are the Spirit. But if you walk according to flesh, you are the flesh. That's why God told Nicodemus that. So humans can give birth to humans. So what is of the flesh can give flesh. But the Spirit can also give birth to spirit. So when you are behaving according to the scriptures, and you are well with one another, because we're being led by the Spirit, don't you think it will produce more good spirits? Bringing people closer to Christ, because our composure is of the Spirit. So when we walk, people see the Holy Spirit, but not us.
Amen.
Amen. Because we're not being dictated according to the flesh, but we are after the Spirit. That's why the Bible says we walk by faith but not by sight. Amen. Because if you go into the world, you'll see people, they say they pray, but they do not stop drinking. They say they pray, they do not stop gossiping. They say they pray, but do not stop fighting. Like every little incident, that person will he wants to, But my brothers and sisters, I ask you, how is that of the Spirit? Amen. How is that bringing us that life, the Spirit of the Holy Spirit within our life?
Amen.
We're going to ask the pastor to continue with Romans 8.
Pasteur va continuer dans Romains 8.
From 5 all the way to 10.
En effet, qui vivent selon la chair s'affectionnent aux choses de la chair. Tandis que ceux qui vivent selon l'esprit s'affectionnent aux choses de l'esprit. Et l'affection de la chair, c'est la mort. Tandis que l'affection de l'esprit, c'est la vie et la paix. Car l'affection de la chair est inimitié contre Dieu, parce qu'elle ne se soumet pas à la loi de Dieu et qu'elle ne le peut même pas. Or, ceux qui vivent selon la chair ne sauraient plaire à Dieu.
Amen.
Pour vous, vous ne vivez pas selon la chair, mais selon l'esprit. Si du moins l'esprit de Dieu habite en vous. Si si quelqu'un n'a pas l'esprit de Christ, il ne lui appartient pas. Et si Christ est en vous, le corps, il est vrai, est mort à cause du péché, mais l'esprit est vie à cause de la justice.
Amen.
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 That right there.
Alors, tu vois,
is clear.
Is that plus simple? Is that clear?
If we do not,
ce qui te salue,
what the Spirit is telling us to do,
ce que nous allons au Saint Esprit sur le bas de notre te salue,
we do not belong to Jesus Christ.
Te salue par les anges mettez.
Amen.
Amen.
We can do a self-examination.
Tu qui consacres un peu examen de conscience,
and ask God.
Pe kutu na nzambe.
What is it that I'm doing? Or what characteristics or traits that I have or defaults that I have that's causing me not to live according to scriptures. If it's anger, get rid of it. If it's lying, get rid of it. If it's stealing, get rid of it. If it's hatred, get rid of it. If it's envy, get rid of it. If it's lust and being always driven to do fleshly desires, get rid of it. Because I don't want it to end up like the Bible says, on that day they will say, Lord, Lord, but I will tell you, surely I never knew you.
Amen.
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 Verse 6
it says, for to be carnal minded is death.
Amen.
Affection yanzoto is a liwa.
But to be spiritually minded
is
life and peace. There won't be no arguments. There won't be no miscommunication with your life, because if you're of the Spirit, everywhere you go, you will bring peace and life. They might come to batter you, but you will have the Spirit of the Lord, and you will be at peace, and you will have good life.
Amen.
Amen.
Verse
6
sends us back again to Galatians 6.
Verse 6 is what in the Bible says in Galatians 6.
Verse 8 and 9. We can start from 7, actually, Pastor.
Verse 8 and 9.
But you can start from 7.
À qui l'on a fait la parole, fasse part de tout ce bien à celui qui l'enseigne. Ne vous y trompez pas, on ne se moque pas de Dieu. Ce qu'un homme aura semé, il le moissonnera aussi. Celui qui sème pour sa chair, moissonnera de la chair la corruption, mais celui qui sème pour l'esprit moissonnera de l'esprit la vie éternelle.
Amen.
Ne nous lassons pas de faire le bien, car nous moissonnerons au temps convenable si nous ne nous relâchons pas.
Amen.
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 Galatians 6,
Galatians
from 6 till 9,
verse 6 and 9.
Let him that is tough in the word, communicate into him that teaches of all good things. Be not deceived. Be not deceived. God is not to mock. Yeah, something not to mock, not to play with. For whatsoever a man soweth, that he shall also reap. Now you are a child of God, but you are sowing anger. What else are you
going to
get? You are a child of God, but you are sowing hatred. What else are you going
to
get? You are a child of God, but you are sowing chaos. What else are you going
to
get? Because if it says, let he who is tough with the word communicate through all things that are good.
Amen.
Amen. I want us to make a quick note. Galatians 6, the whole chapter, talks about the spirit of the fruit. Amen. So if we go home and we look at Galatians 6 again, we will see those good fruits. Now back to verse 7. Amen.
Amen.
Verse 7 says, be not deceived, God is not to mock.
On se moque pas de Dieu.
Amen.
Amen.
If you read what you reap is what you sow. And the Bible says for it to be the spirit of life, which is the Holy Spirit of God. And when we look into the scriptures, when it talks about love, love doesn't envy us, love is not jealous, love is not hatred, love is not all this. Where does it say those things are bad? Those are the good stuff.
What is any below malam?
The spirit that we're supposed to have is what God gives us of the good stuff. Not the bad ones. Amen.
Amen.
Verse 8. For he that soweth to his flesh shall reap the corruption.
Corruption.
Amen.
Amen.
But he that soweth out to the Spirit shall reap the spirit of everlasting life. Amen.
Amen.
Let us not be worried in well
and
well doing, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not, if we don't perish, if we faint not. So if we don't pretty much lose all this purpose. Amen.
Amen.
So hold on to the good works. The spirit of life
is pure born.
Not chaos. Not of the flesh. Back to Romans 8. Verse 7. Because a carnal minded is an enemy to the Lord.
Is
against God.
Amen.
Amen. For it is not subjected of the law of God. And indeed cannot be of God. Amen.
Amen.
So if you have all those things in you, it's only bad. Do you think you belong to God? Not at all. Because we just read it. The carnal minded is the enemy of God. And cannot be of God. Amen.
Amen.
Verse 8 it says, so then.
Verse 8 le bine disoboy.
So then they that are of the flesh cannot please God.
Amen.
Amen.
How do you walk after the flesh?
Well,
no, the pastor's not here, so let me drink a little bit. Ah, this person always gets on my nerves, man. You yourself are already walking with that ticking bomb to get angry. So you're waiting for that person to just step on your toe. I was looking for this anger all day. You're waking up yourself saying, today if somebody try me, they will see. Child of God. Why? Those are the things the flesh leads us to do. But if you are the Spirit of God, the Spirit of life, consciously, when you're sitting and you're continuously praying to God, you'll be filled with the Holy Spirit. That even if you go outside, if they step on your toe, the Spirit of God is life and peace, that won't have no effect.
Amen.
Amen.
Let's give God a round of applause for a second. Because we are no longer of this world, like the Bible says. You are in the world, but you're not of the world. But why are we ourselves? We are literally taking ourselves back into the world to walk after the flesh, to walk with all these worldly desires. When we already know, we are of God. The Bible says in the book of James, when you do the things that you know you should not do, that is a sin. So you know right from wrong, and you still do it anyway. I'm a child of God. God is have grace. It's by God's grace I'll be okay. Wrong. You should walk after the Spirit, not the flesh. You should walk after the Holy Spirit of God, not what is of the world. Amen.
Amen.
Verse 9. But you are not of the flesh, but in the Spirit. If so be that the Spirit of God will dwell in you. If any man have not the Spirit of God, he is not of his. Amen.
Amen.
But if Christ be in you, the body is dead. Because of sin. But the Spirit is life because of righteousness. Paul said, to live is Christ, to die is gain.
Amen.
Because if I'm living off of Christ. All the flesh and desires, all the things in the world, I don't want it. I'm all in. I'm all for Christ. Anger, betrayal, envy, all those things. What God says, if we are of Christ, He's dwelling in us.
Oh, yes, I'll be so kito zaba. Oh, yeah, yes, I can hear.
How can we satisfy that? We silenced everything else that's bad.
Amen.
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 We tell everything that is wrong and against the Bible to be quiet. You have no place here.
Et nous en parlons non avec des discours car c'est de la sagesse humaine, mais avec ce qu'en sait l'esprit, employant un langage spirituel pour les choses spirituelles. Mais l'homme naturel n'accepte pas les choses de l'esprit de Dieu, car elles sont une folie pour lui. Et il ne peut les connaître parce que c'est spirituellement qu'on en juge.
Amen.
Amen.
Parce que c'est comme 12, one more time, 12, one more time.
12?
Mm-hmm.
Or, nous n'avons pas reçu l'esprit du monde, mais l'esprit qui vient de Dieu, afin que nous connaissions les choses que Dieu nous a donné par sa grâce.
Amen.
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 Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the spirit which is of God, that we might know the things that are freely given into us by God. By His grace. Amen.
Amen.
If we do not receive the spirit of the world, so why is anger or any other things of the flesh doing in your life? Why is hatred doing in your life? Oh yeah, because you're not of God.
Because
if we say we are of God, then those things do not belong. Like Michael rebuked Satan, you must also rebuke all those spirits.
Amen.
Amen. Because we have that capability. Because the spirit of the world does not belong to God. So we have the spirit of God. So we can too remove all those spirits. Which things also we speak, not in the words of men's wisdom, or a way of teaching of men, but which the Holy Ghost teacheth. So even if by just speaking, it should be bringing forth blessings. Eh?
We're
supposed to go talk about good things for one another. That's showing that good spirit within us. When we start doing the opposite of that, we are showing God that we do not belong to Him.
Amen.
Amen.
Comparing spiritual things with one another.
To compare misala ya esprit avec chacun de nous.
So the spirit with the spirit. So knowing if I'm walking in good condition with the spirit, I know my brother Poppy's in good, we will walk along the same path.
Aussi longtemps que tu as dit qu'on dit entre L'esprit de Dieu pour autant pour l'entendre mon condamne de concert.
But if we're not, we're gonna keep butting heads.
Mais celle qui t'ose aller combiner esprit moroté t'ose aller toujours n'a pas problème.
And then we're gonna come in front of the people saying I'm a Christian.
Peut t'ose aller bosser avant tout coloba t'ose aller bas chrétien.
Nobody's perfect.
Mutata moroté est parfait.
But we should not keep letting those old ways dictate our flesh.
Mais c'est une épisode que tout si capisalé le oyo ya ya papo sanzolo est la place na bon mon épisode.
Because it doesn't belong there. People who say, nobody's perfect, so I must do what I have to do, wrong. Us not being perfect is a measurement to, we're not going to be perfect in the scriptures spiritually. But to the world, there is no qualification. Because if I'm not a sinner, if I'm not a thief, I'm perfect. But in the spirit, I'm still getting better. I'm still learning. I'm still growing. I'm still evolving. The spirit is bringing me back every time I fall to recognize this is where you fall. Get back up, ask forgiveness, repent, and keep going. That's the spirit of life. It doesn't envy. It doesn't do anything bad to one another. Verse 14 says, but the nature of man received not the things of the Spirit of God. For they are foolishness unto them,
entre bango,
neither can they know them.
Naba oyo bayebi bango.
So this a regular person
mutu normal
won't understand the things of the spirit.
A vous comprendre ma corps esprité.
Because it doesn't sit well with them.
Pour edo vanda normal tena esprité.
Because they're not spiritually discerned.
Pour bazali spirituellement te selon l'ilobe.
But we are. Why do we go back and think like the foolish men? The way we act as if we don't know the scriptures. The way we behave, the way we talk, the way we think, the way we walk. As if you never read the word. The spirit of life. We need to walk after the spirit of life. We have not received the spirit of the world, but the spirit of God, the spirit of life. Into God, it will lead us into righteousness. That when we hear the word of God, we don't dismiss it. Because we are deceiving ourselves. But if we hold on to the spirit of life, like it says in 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 12, the way it's going to teach us, the Holy Ghost is going to guide us, we will have what Romans 10 said, life and peace.
Amen.
Today, so if the Spirit talks to you about the spirit of life, the spirit of joy, life, and peace, we hear it, and we don't act on what the Spirit is telling us, we are deceiving ourselves. Amen.
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 My word. Not my word, the scriptures. Harden not your heart. Harden not your heart. The Holy Scriptures are said. We have to listen. We have to do. We have to obey. Today, you and I are hearing this word, not because I just want to say it, but because God gave it to us for a reason. Because the spirit that is in us, it's conflicting with what the spirit of God is. But we can't let it. Because we know the truth. Because once we open up our hearts and we let the Spirit of God sit within us, nothing else will matter. We'll have life and peace. Just like the Bible says, when God said, He's knocking on the door. He's waiting for you to open. If you open, He will come in and sit with you. That's in Revelation 3, verse 20. We're going to ask the pastor to read.
Apocalypse 3, 23.
Vince till 22. Amen.
Voici, je m'étais à la porte et je frappe. Si quelqu'un entend ma voix, et ouvre la porte, j'entrerai chez lui. Je souperai avec lui, et lui avec moi. Celui qui vaincra, je le ferai asseoir avec moi sur mon trône, comme moi j'ai vaincu et me suis assis avec mon Père sur son trône. Que celui qui a des oreilles entendre ce que l'Esprit dit aux églises. Amen.
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 Amen. Let's give a round of applause for the Lord right there. Behold, I stand at the door. And I'm knocking. If any man hear my voice and open the door, I will come in unto him and I will sit with him and he with me. We just read the Spirit of Life. Says the spirit of life, which is God, dwells within us. So that means He's with us. There's no room for anger, envy, lust, drinking, lying, stealing, killing, all those bad things. Because once we say we have the Spirit of God and we do those other things, the Bible says we are not of His. That means when God is knocking, you are ignoring that knock. That means you are ignoring. Yeah. Verse 21 says, to him that overcometh, I will grant to sit with me at my throne.
Amen.
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 Even as I overcame, even when I overcame, that means I was able to win everything in the world. We too can do the same. Amen.
Amen.
We will sit at the right throne with the Father in heaven.
Amen.
He that has ears, let him he hear what the Spirit of God, of course, has said unto the church. The church is you and I. The church is us when we let God lead us. The church is everywhere we go because we are walking with that Lord that the Spirit says. Because if we dismiss it, Like James 1 says, if you do not do what the word said, you are deceiving yourself. Amen.
Amen.
The spirit of life. The spirit of Christ. The spirit of Christ. Dwells within us. Because it's going to teach us. It's going to lead us. It's going to guide us. In every step of the way. If you are associated with any other thing, rebuke it. If you are still attached to your anger, your harsh words, or your bad thinking, like the Bible says, a carnal mind is not of God. I urge you, my brothers and sisters, to get rid of it. Let the Spirit of Christ that dwells within you take control. In every single aspect of your life. So you will know how to not just be a better person for your brothers or sisters, your mothers, your wife, your husband. But a child of God. May the Lord's mercy bless you, and may the Lord's love be with you.